Good morning, and welcome to worship with Gloucester Salvation Army this Sunday, the 1st of November. In the couple of weeks since we last shared together on this channel, many things have happened in this country. Some positive, some less so. But we can be confident that through it all, God is there, putting people and plans into action. A little later on, we're going to be looking at a number of stories from the Bible. But to begin with, let's sing together.
Come set your rule and reign in our hearts again. Increase in us, we pray. Unveil why we're made. Come set our hearts ablaze with hope, like wildfire in our very soul. We are your church. We need your power in us.
We seek your kingdom.
We seek your kingdom first. Hunger and we thirst, refuse to waste our lives, for you're our joy and pride. To see the happy thoughts, the hurt, the sick, the poor at peace, we lay down our lives for heaven's goals. We are church, we pray revive this earth. Build your kingdom here. Let the darkness fear. Show your mighty hand. Heal our streets. Set your church. Your kingdom's power, reaching the near and far. No force of hell can stop your beauty changing heart. You made us for much more than this. Awake the kingdom seed in us. Fill us with the strength and love of Christ. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in
hide his face. I rest on his unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds beyond the veil. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong, Savior's love through the storm. He is Lord, Lord of all. When he shall come with trumpet sound, oh, may I then on him be found, dressed in his righteousness alone. Faultless I stand before the throne. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong, Savior's love through the storm. He is Lord, Lord of all.
We have come to the point in our meeting where it's time to reflect, time to talk to God. During lockdown, the humble jigsaw puzzle has seen a surge in popularity as people try to find ways to entertain themselves when many other activities have been taken away from them. So this morning I'm going to use a jigsaw puzzle to help us pray. As I hold up the first piece, I'm going to pray for myself, and perhaps you would like to join me and pray for yourself right now. Father God, I ask you that you would be all I need right now. I want to thank you for all the good things in my life. As I hold this first corner piece up, Lord, I want to ask that you would help me to see the big picture of the plan you have for my life. Amen. As I hold up the second piece, I see that it reaches outwards. Father God, we pray for all the people who reach out to help others and to show your love to them. Thank you for all the people in our lives who are important to us and who show love to us. Amen. Now as I hold up this third piece, I see it has spaces waiting to be filled. So Father God, we pray for anyone who has lost something or someone, or who feels that they have something missing in their lives. Lord, surround these people with your love and help them to know that they are loved by you. Amen. You know, sometimes there are some pieces that they just don't fit, you know. So we're going to use these right now. And Father God, we pray for people who find it hard to fit in. People who have moved to a new place. People who feel they have no friends and people who are bullied. Lord, we pray that these people would feel your love and find peace, friends and happiness. Amen. And eventually, you know, we get to hold up the whole puzzle in our hands. So Lord, as I hold this, I pray for everybody watching, for all our communities and for all who are important to us. Lord, bless us all. Amen.
This morning we're going to be looking at a few stories about young people in the Bible. Children are such an important part of our church family and are an integral part of how we build and expand God's kingdom here on earth. The band piece this morning is called Temple Praise, written by Kenneth Downing. It contains the well-known chorus, "Building up the temple, building up the temple of the Lord. Boys, won't you help us? Girls, won't you help us? Building up the temple of the Lord." Listen and enjoy the message from the band.
Thank you. Bible reading is from 1 Samuel chapter 17. This is a story about the Israelite army, the Philistine army, and an ordinary boy who was braver than the lot of them. The Israelites were God's people, and they were ruled by King Saul. They weren't getting on with the Philistines, so Saul and his soldiers went to fight the Philistines. However, the Philistines' army had a giant of a man called Goliath. Goliath was huge, taller than anyone you have ever seen. He was a great warrior, so everyone was scared of him. No one wanted to fight him. Every morning and every evening, Goliath stood there shouting, "I dare you to fight me! I dare anyone to fight me!" David was a young shepherd boy from an Israelite family, just an ordinary boy who looked after sheep. He was the youngest of 8 brothers. 3 of David's older brothers were soldiers in King Saul's army. One day, David's father sent him out to find how his brothers were getting on. When he got there, David could hear Goliath shouting at King Saul's army, "I dare you to fight me! I dare any of you to come and fight me!" No one moved. David looked at the other soldiers. This was God's army, and no one was doing anything to sort out this big bully. David went to see the king. "I'm not scared. I can fight Goliath for you," he told King Saul. David was only a boy, but he had a very special friend. He was friends with God. When he was at home, he sat out in the fields, looking after the sheep, talking to God and singing songs about him. Sometimes a lion or bear tried to take a lamb, and David had to fight them off. God kept David safe from lions and bears. David only had the courage because he knew that God would keep him safe from this giant too. King Saul gave David his armour, but the king's armour was too big and heavy for David. He couldn't possibly fight in that, and anyway, he didn't need it. He had God on his side. So David went to fight Goliath in his own clothes. On his way, he picked up 5 smooth stones and put them in his bag. When Goliath saw him coming, he jeered at David. "What is this? A boy with nothing more than a sling, and you have come to fight me?" David took one of the 5 stones from his bag, put it in his sling and fired it at Goliath. The stone hit Goliath right on the forehead and killed him stone dead.
Thank you. Lord, I want to bring to you the children and young people of our congregation as they learn to live with the new normal in these times. I pray that you will keep them safe and healthy in the coming weeks and months. Amen.
When I say young people in the Bible, who springs to mind for you? Maybe it's David from our Bible reading? Or perhaps the boy with 5 loaves and 2 fish? Or does your mind take you straight to Jesus? Over the last 2 weeks, young people have been at the front of the minds of, I'm sure, most people in this country, with all that's happening regarding free school meals. Children are such an important part of church, and I'm proud to be part of one that cares so deeply for its young people. Time and time again in the Bible, we see stories of young people being underestimated, then achieving simply incredible things. A great example is David from the Bible reading earlier, a story I'm sure we all recognise. David heard Goliath's defiance of God's army and refused to do nothing about it. He was laughed at, and King Saul says to him, "You're only a boy." But David insisted, confident that the Lord who rescued me from the claws of the lion and the bear will rescue me from this Philistine. Verse 37. Saul eventually gave in, and then David was underestimated by someone else, Goliath, which gave him the opportunity he needed to get the victory. If God had not put David specifically in that place at that time and been with him all the way, who knows what Goliath would have done to the Israelites. A few weeks ago, we heard about Daniel and his friends. They were men of great faith, standing up for what they believed, no matter the obstacle. When Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were thrown into the furnace by Nebuchadnezzar, they were somewhere between 10 and 30 years old, we believe. I'm sure their youthfulness played a large part in changing Nebuchadnezzar's heart when 3 boys walked out of a furnace completely unharmed. God not only protected them from threat, but used them and their young ages to expand his kingdom on earth. Time and time again, we see God using young people to do things no one could expect them to do. However, it would be unfair to say that alone, children are the future of the church. As a church family, we are all dependent on each other, using each other's gifts to support our church and God's work. In Exodus 7, verse 7, we're told that when Moses and Aaron speak to Pharaoh to demand the Israelites' freedom, they were 80 and 83 years old, respectively. From there, they were in the wilderness for 40 years. Although there was plenty of complaining and resistance from the Israelites, I imagine they must have been inspired by this man Moses, over 100 years old, leading them through the wilderness. So then, it's important that we find a balance. Young people often come with enthusiasm and big ideas, like David. David was certain that God would be with him, and that God's plan was to use him in that situation. It's important that as older people, we do not be like the soldiers and brothers of David, trying to deter or talk down to the younger people, but instead encourage and support them. Without the mentorship and experience that comes with age, ideas could simply flash and burn. By using each other's different attributes in harmony, we can help to grow each other's faiths, our own faiths, and ultimately help build God's temple here on earth. Crucially though, as we sang earlier, a temple cannot be built without the cornerstone. In all that we do, we must remember Jesus' example. He was both a child that has changed billions of lives, and a man who encouraged children in helping others. Let's do everything together, as a church, through Jesus.
Thank you.
Let's pray together. Lord, thank you for the example you set for us in the Bible. Help us to support each other, using our different experiences to expand your temple here. Let us not forget that you are the cornerstone, pivotal to all that we do and say. Amen. To close, we're going to sing a song that the training band opened our worship with an arrangement of. A song that talks of many characters from the Bible, and a hint at what God did through them. God bless you as you go about your daily life this next week. Let's sing together.